Today marks 50 years since riots sparked between police and protesters outside a gay bar in New York.
And tonight, local advocates marched through the streets of South City to show support for transgender St. Louisans. Fox News' Katie Corman joins us now from downtown with why this march is so significant. Katie.
On the anniversary of the Stonewall riots, members of the transgender community and allies marched through South St. Louis without police presence to highlight those who have fought for equality and those who continue to fight for equality. Snow cones, support, and a touch of glitter.
We're here to celebrate trans joy.
And march to kick off a weekend of pride events. This event celebrating trans, non-binary, and gender non-conforming St. Louisans.
We need trans expansive folks to take up space in beautiful ways. We need to have things for us and about us and by us, and this is a perfect opportunity.
This opportunity for visibility even more important after disagreements over uniformed police officers marching in the St. Louis Pride Parade prompted the Grand Marshal to back out. The Metro Trans Umbrella Group was supposed to lead the parade and asked officers in uniform to not participate in honor of the Stonewall anniversary.
Police represent a very particular threat to our community, as opposed to maybe the ideas of safety that other people have.
In the spirit of inclusion, Pride St. Louis reached an agreement with the city, and ultimately, uniformed officers were invited to participate.
This march is a chance for us to kind of take back our narrative and say, regardless of whether or not institutions, cities, mayors, other people keep promises to us as a community, we're going to keep our promise to ourselves and remind each other that we deserve spaces for joy, we've survived another year, and that we're excited to just spend time together.
Advocates say transphobia is a problem in St. Louis, and transgender St. Louisans struggle with housing, hunger, employment, and health care.
We need support, we need our allies behind us, and we need to keep on having conversations. Way broader than a parade. We need to have conversations about trans lives and how we experience the world.
The advocates I spoke with say there are a number of ways to show your support and alliance with the transgender community. I will link you to some of those resources. Just look for this story in your Fox 2 app. Live in downtown St. Louis, Katie Corman, Fox 2 News.
And Pride St. Louis's festival is happening all weekend, starting tomorrow morning with a military wreath-laying ceremony at 10 on the steps of Soldiers Memorial. The festival gates open tomorrow morning at 11. There will be live music, a Stonewall history exhibit, and a children's area. The annual parade steps off at noon on Sunday on Market Street. Now, the festival runs until 7 Saturday evening and until 6 Sunday evening.